that our children are demanding, the meaningful conversations that are going to wake us up, the meaningful conversations that are going to do the damage that has been done to our psyche, to our brains. We must wake up. It is just that simple. We must say no to continued expectation. We must say no to feeling inferior for no good reason except that they told us so. This conversation must take place on every inch of soil on this beloved continent. Too many of us are still fast asleep. And until each and every one of us has a serious conversation with the image in the mirror, nothing, and I mean nothing that we do is going to change. Garbage in, garbage out. You go to that boardroom table with a colonized mind, garbage in, garbage out. The most dangerous thing for Africa today is a colonized African. Because that is the African that is still going to be used as an instrument of our own self-destruction. They come from the World Bank looking like you and I, dishing out bad policies for the continent. Why? Because the mind is still in the gutter. They come from so many other international organizations. Instead of speaking truth to power and sharing what they know to make sure that our continent is going in the right direction, they choose to serve the wrong master. And whatever you do to the African, we must let them know that we will stand up and we will unite and we will push back. That's all we have to do. Push back. Stand up and push back.
Sister Arikana and all those who have assembled here under the aegis of ADDI, permit me to congratulate you, because what you have done is indicative of the deep-seated desire to liberate Africa from the chains of sorrow and want. And the Christ of Ghana is as emblematic as it is symbolic. And in many ways, you are harbingers for a big storm that is coming to this part of the world. And Ghana, if you permit me, plays a critical part in the history of Africa. And I believe that the choice of Ghana was deliberate for that reason. When Ghana, on the 6th day of March 1957, became the first country to begin our continuing battle of exercising the ghost of the curse of Bali, the founding father of independent Ghana, Kwame Nkrumah, said that until the rest of Africa is free, the independence of Ghana means nothing. And I dare say that that gives meaning to the statement that we must be helped to fight our oppressors with all our mind and might. Yes. And we are assembled here to give meaning to those words. The history of the economic regeneration of Africa is not a new one. It has always sat in the inner recesses of the hearts and minds of our forebears. When Marcus Garvey, those many years, founded the Black Star and told Africans to go back to Africa, he was remembering the need to come back home. He discovered that when you go out there, and you imagine that the grass is green on the other side, the truth is that it's green on the other side because it has been watered. Ooh. And we too are now saying that the grass on this side can't be greener, but we must water it. So, we have come here, and our echo is ADDI, and in ADDI we have water in it. And we want to water this grass on this side that it may become green.